You may have already have seen this engine in a previous video of mine, but I decided to remake this video with a bit more information about the engine. This was made back in 2017 and was the first scratch-built engine that I had made, and only the third model engine that I'd built, following from a basic oscillator and then Elmer's wobble plate engine. This design is based on a mill-style horizontal engine, which uses a double-acting cylinder with a slide valve and a twin flywheel setup. The engine cylinder is 2 inches long and was made from a recycled part from a pallet truck. This was simply turned and then bored to 3/4 inch, with a piston stroke of 1.5 inches. The cylinder has been soft soldered to a piece of brass and then fixed to the support by machine screws. The port face was also soft soldered to the cylinder and the steam chest and slide valve machined to suit. The valve is connected to an eccentric hub on the axle, with the use of a clevis fork joint to allow for the oscillation movement. The eccentric shear is a brass bush similar to this, which has been turned with a 1/8 inch offset to produce a 1/4 inch eccentric throw to drive the valve. This is fixed to the axle with a grub screw, and a simple brass ring is used as the eccentric strap, which the valve rod simply screws into a tapped hole. The bearing supports were made from 1/2 inch aluminium plate and fitted with sintered bronze bearings known as oil light bearings. These were then drilled through from the top, and some oil cups were then turned from brass and fitted to allow oil to penetrate to the axle shaft. The axle and crank was manufactured by using 2 steel plates which have been permanently fixed to the silver steel axle shaft by using tight-fitting dowel pins pressed into the holes drilled through the plates and the shaft, such as this one here. The same is done for the journal pin, and then the excess part of the axle removed to create the crank. The connecting rod was made from brass in a similar fashion as I demonstrated in my Rob Roy vertical engine build videos, with a phosphor bronze split bearing which is fitted around the crank journal. This then connects with the clevis joint to the brass crosshead, which is held along the cylinder axis with the crosshead slide guides. These are 2 parallel pieces of 1/4 inch mild steel set on aluminium supports with machine screws, and this accurately aligns the piston rod with the cylinder. The flywheels were made from 3-inch brass round bar, machined to 5/8 inch. These have a recess turned on the faces to allow a boss to be formed to accept a grub screw for fixing to the axle. The piston rod enters the cylinder through a reamed hole in the cylinder cover, which also has a compression gland fitted with a graphite coated yarn to help it seal, yet still allowing for free movement of the piston rod into the cylinder. The opposite end of the cylinder has been capped off with a matching steel plate. And to this day, I don't know why I chose 5-hole bolt circle instead of 6, which would have looked nicer and more symmetrical. But I guess I had a reason at the time. Or maybe not. I don't know. Now, this engine is fairly basic, and being my first double-acting cylinder build, it was my first attempt at building a slide valve from scratch. It certainly won't win any prizes for efficiency, as it is very leaky and you can hear the air escaping from the pour seal between the valve and the port face. But all said and done, the engine runs exceptionally smooth and is a joy to watch. Thanks for watching.